Hi, welcome back to another Terranscapes video. I'm Mike, I will be your host today, and this is part two of the process I went through to make a wire armature tree and some of the caveats to consider or avoid. If you are a new viewer to the series, or you're a brand new viewer to the channel, well, thank you. Jumping in here is not the right place. You should go back and watch part one because the intro there has a lot of information about why I'm showing this video and some of the things to consider. If you forgot what that intro had, I'm going to put up a quick screen here that has a very brief summary. And if you want to pause it to read it, you can. With that said, I don't need any more intro on this one. Let's jump into part two and see how the tree has progressed.
Okay. All right, so this one I'm going to have come in a little lower because of that main core, which is not going to be easy to twist. So I'm going to have other things wrapping around it, which means I'm going to use this one at the end up a little higher so that I can wrap around it with those wires as well. So let's do this. First thing we're going to do is we're going to cut off a good chunk of this. I'm sure by now you can gather that I don't always have a clear vision about where each wire is going. See, I don't feel like that join right there is really bulked up enough. Branches at the unions get quite thick because of the tremendous forces that they are exerting. That the branch is exerting because of its, essentially it's a lever. I forget which class, that might be a third class lever. So the fulcrum is very far away from the weight that the lever has on it. So anyway, it's under a lot of force. Let's try this. I feel pretty good about that join. That does not have any cabling look to it. You compare it to here, how we've joined here, and notice that void right there. And here we have a nice filled-in underside, which is the way it should look. So just to bring you up to speed, I've been wrapping wire up and down, and you'll notice I've started moving to the copper wire, which has been nice because it is a very thin gauge. If you recall, we are using 28 gauge,
The nice thing about it is that the copper is very ductile. It's easy to bend and twist, but it's easy to get some reasonable tight spacing on some of the coils. And I have been building the bottoms of these branches. And so, for instance, I have not really done this one, and its uniform length all the way out here actually doesn't look that natural. And I haven't really done this kind of work in my past trees, and I see a real advantage to it. So the nice thing is you can wrap tight coils, and that's going to be a little easier to fill, and it gives you a lot of control over the thickness of the branch as it descends. So I'm going to keep going with this and thicken this area here, and then thicken this area here, and then do a lot of tight wrapping around the trunk so that I can flesh it out, make it a little bit bigger, but also smooth it out so that it will be easier to cover with the bark when we get to that stage. So that's where I'm at, and I think I'm going to continue. Just occurred to me that the copper wire in particular, because it's so soft, as I'm working with the tree, it is starting to unwrap in some areas, and that is just becoming annoying. And so I decided right now that it would be helpful if I put a little CA on some of these spots. This area to me was starting to get a little thick, although now that I've added this, I probably should reinforce this area a little bit more. But I really stopped working down here to just build up this area. So I probably will add just a little bit more here. And of course, this looks a little thicker than here. So I'll add a little bit here, and I'll work my way down to here. And then I'll work on this branch. And I've been looking at the tree, and I've been thinking about the branches. And I think that it would look more interesting with a secondary but fairly large branch coming off of this. As it is right now, we have a kind of a uniform look where all the major branches join at the tree, and that's not always the case. And I think adding a little bit of a larger branch on this section, then when it's bent down, we can have another branch coming off of it. And I think that's going to add quite a bit to the tree. But I should mention at this point that with a little cleanup down here, you'd be most people would be happy to stop. I don't want to encourage you to go further than you need to, but it is an interesting little project to work on. I think it's quite relaxing to wrap a tree like this. What I haven't been doing, which I recommend you do, is actually look at pictures of trees and pick one that you like and try to model it. I should be doing that myself, and I think it's going to be interesting for me to look at the end and see exactly how well I've done with the main armature of the tree. So it's kind of a fun little exercise for me. If you ever feel second doubts about how you are doing with your tree, definitely take a look at some photos and see what you think. So I'm gonna work on making a secondary branch here, and then I'll join it, and we come back and we'll take a look at how it's coming along. And the secondary branch I'm going to make is formed just like the rest of these, so there's no real trick to it, and I don't think you need to see the whole process on that. So we'll be back in a few seconds and we'll take a look at how that came out. So having finished, to my somewhat satisfaction, the base of the tree here, it's taken a different form than what you would normally see. Because I've done secondary wrapping around it, it's forming this little bit of a bulbous end. Now, in a typical wire armature tree, you would trail all the wires down from the branches and twist them, and that would not create this look. So I'm not worried about this, however, because when I place it into the diorama, I'm able to bury it to whatever degree I feel suits me. However, I would like to have some of these wires free and exposed so that I could use them to make roots. I have played with that in the past and have not been really satisfied with the results that I got, and I'd like to make a much stronger effort this time to really have some substantial roots, maybe growing over a rock or something, which will look really interesting. So what I'm about to do is to clip out some of these wires, break these free, and then have the ability to have a slightly flatter end, and then I can have roots coming off of it. So that's what I'm about to do now. Before I do that, would I recommend this technique? Maybe. So just as I was wrapping up the roots, literally and figuratively, it occurred to me that I could bring some wire around the base to kind of make a flange at the bottom of the tree. Where the tree meets roots, it tends to widen and join a little more smoothly than some kind of a harsh delineation. So I started to add that wire and I really like the effect that I'm getting. So I'm going to add just a little bit more and see if I can make that transition just a little bit smoother. And I'm going to go back to the 26 gauge. I was obviously using the 28 gauge copper, but I think I'll get a little faster fill with the 26 gauge. And I'm cutting larger pieces now so that I can continue the wrap without going from small piece to small piece. Plus it's less ends I have to glue down, as I do find I've been having to super glue spots regularly. So here I'm just feeding it through a wire just to help bind it for the first couple of wraps. And that has worked out sort of okay. Sometimes it pulls out, depends on the wire. Because the copper is more flexible, it tends to not want to stay attached. Now, to be fair, I could do some of this sort of bulking up of this base just by using, you know, say the bark mixture, but I feel like I'd rather start from the best, the best position right from the get-go, and rather than try to rely on building it up, because things, they have dry times, and that means I might have to do multiple layers, and I'd rather just get it as close as I can to what the final shape will be. And by doing some loops around the roots themselves rather than just following the base of the tree, it of course secures everything a little bit tighter, but also helps bulk up that transition right at the roots, right at the root join. And so I think that's going to help make that transition a little bit more, a little more smooth, a little more realistic. Of course, one, I don't know if you want to call it a risk, but when you add wire at the end, that's not material that you can easily take away should you not like the final flare at the bottom, whereas if you were building it up with another material after the fact, you know, that material could be scraped away or sand it off, or you could make adjustments then, and this will not allow me to make adjustments. So that's one thing to consider if you want to leave yourself a little room for flexibility. How's that? So at this point, we can now shape our tree and take a look at what its actual form is going to be, since it's all kind of compressed at the moment. So let's do this. And so as I adjust the branches, trying to give them some shape, one of the things that I think about is trying to fill voids. You have to imagine, of course, a little bit of foliage on this, but trees, as most plants do, try to maximize the amount of light that they can absorb, get exposed to. So their branches tend to open up into areas where they're getting more sun. Maybe that sounds a little self-evident, but the point being that I try to look at where light would be falling and then think about how I can fill that area with some branch work. But I think there's something rewarding about free-forming it as well. It's sort of, you know, it's the tree of your imagination. After all, Bob Ross would say, don't worry, just make a happy tree. We're just going to make a happy tree. It's going to sit by our little stream, our little river scene. Actually, I just realized I'm not necessarily modeling these branches 100% accurately. As it occurs to me, you don't typically see the branches pointing up. they don't stand up because the leaves aren't exposed to the maximum light. The branches tend to come out flat so that the leaves are evenly distributed and can get the most light. So things like this. This is not quite, there we go. It's funny, in all the trees, not that I've made, well, no, I've made a lot of trees, even if they're woodland scenics armatures, I never quite thought of it exactly like that before, which is silly, but goes to show that, you know, you're always learning. I often say that your brain can only focus on so many things that are new. So when you're first doing a piece, there's a lot of fundamentals that you're trying to stay focused on. And as those fundamentals become a little bit more second nature, then you're able to step back and say, oh, well, what about this? I haven't done that before. I think that looks pretty good. And at the bottom here, I've taken the core. I've trimmed it down so there aren't quite so many wires. I used some of those flangey wires to make some of the roots and then added some to the roots themselves, some extra wires, of course. But this makes a nice pin. And then I can hot glue it and use this as the foundation to work on it as we continue. And then I'm able to remove it pretty easily and then pop it into the display. So there.
So I hope you enjoyed watching the continuing process on making the tree. I do not have any final thoughts yet because the tree is not finished, and you will see those at the... What is that? That's a move. You will see those at the end of part three. Now, if you got to this ending and you did not watch the intro, and you should go back to part one and watch the intro there, because I feel like I'm going to get a lot of comments on these videos, and I tried very hard to address a lot of those concerns or questions up front. Hopefully, you will be coming back for part three to see the finish of the armature. Questions and comments are always welcome down below. Please feel free. I'm working on catching up. I might be caught up by the time you see this. Hopefully you will be coming back to see part three and to see how I wrapped up the tree. Get it? Wrapped up. Because you know that I will be back soon with another Terranscapes video.